Thank you. not to happen among you. No, anyone who wants to be great among you must be your servant. Anyone who wants to be first among you must be your slave. Just as the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. The gospel, the good news from our Lord.
So
great cards and poems great night. So I'm grateful for all my first love of jazz radio. Then when I came to Evansville in 1968, we were still a segregated city. We had a curfew the night I came into Evansville in 1968, August, late August, 23rd, 24th, right there. We sat on the porch because we couldn't go out in the streets. They had riots down the governor and Lincoln. So, you know, those things we condone, that's segregation of things, those are some of our sins. And God is one of the things John did when he heard. So let's ask them to forgive us for the sins we committed against them, and we forgive them for the sins they committed against us. He said that about Christians, but really, I think he did that for all of us. When I came to them to jazz radio, I got involved with school. I used to teach in jazz at St. I was called St. Joseph 10th Street School, I guess you would say. But as I came to jazz collecting, as I came to Evansville, I got more and more involved in the community here. And it took a while for me to come back to home because some of these people were the people that I carried papers to. I didn't know how they would accept me. Anyhow, it's like my days in jazz, but then you know that's what brought the people into my life. And of course, he became like an assistant pastor. Before that, I had a team, we had the sisters working together with us priests. You know, there was a wonderful spirit that God sent the spirit to all people. And that was one of the things that switched instead of from top down, God's spirit's working in all of us. All of us have gifts, therefore we are to use our gifts. We're not just helping priests, we're living true to our baptismal commitment. And so it was at that time then we became more and more aware of how we are to work together. All of us share the priesthood of Christ. All of us are being disciples. As Bishop Shea, you made a big pitch for stewardship and tithe. I used to be Protestant, well, I agree with that one too. The '80s would be okay to push for that. It was actually in the '70s when we started that. And I think that's one of the things I've worked hard on, stewardship, proportional giving. Many people say, oh, that's just Father Temple's ideas. Well, I believe those are God's ideas. It's not mine. And a lot of people said, he's a lone ranger, he does what he wants to do. I like to believe I did what Christ wanted to do. That's what I try to do. And if you go on and on and on, St. Teresa, we had school. We believe the school had to be supported by everybody, not just by the parents. We provided Catholic school education for any faithful member who went to the church, went to grade school, even high school, and did that at St. Teresa, and according to our man, which shape. Blessed there, of course, I'm blessed with the sisters and the little sisters until they deserve this. We still love all the little sisters. Sisters, Benedictines, the daughters, Franciscans, all who are here today, because in some way you've helped to shape my life. But we can go on and on and on, but I want to also talk a little bit about some of the hopes that I have in the Catholic tradition. I want you to know I do love the Catholic tradition, otherwise I would not be a priest today. I would be something else, I'm sure, but I also believe that just as things change with the Second Vatican Council, we still need to change. Change is a constant. You know, when you're right, you rot. When you read, you grow. In other words, as long as you and I are changing and growing in the Spirit of Christ, we're going to get greater and greater. One of the biggest things I think that we need to change in our Catholic tradition is that celibacy should be optional. You know, we should have a married clergy. We would not be merging these parishes together, all of us hating that. Back in the 80s, I guess, Bishop Shea started that battle for him to continue the merging of parishes. And I used to always say, we're working on the wrong end. We don't have to try to figure out how to merge parishes. We're preserving the tradition at the expense of the mission. We're supposed to be expanding. We need to invite back our brother priests who are married. You know, by not inviting back, we can put a negative on marriage. You know, there are a lot of wonderful married people and wonderful servants. Even better than some of us priests, you know, the doctors, different people who commit their life to service. So I really do believe and hope that one day we will have optional celibacy, we will have married people, married men, was supposed to be a leader to ordain women to be a deacon. There were deacons in the early days of the church, but today the church will do that. I feel that we need to move forward to that day that one day women will have equality in our church as well as us men.
Courage to be brother or a sister, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Father Ted has been a boost of trust to those who are fearful, or an increase of faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Father Ted has been a boost of compassion to the sick and to the dying, for comfort and peace for those who are suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Gratitude for all who have boosted us on our way in life, especially for Father Ted's parents, brothers, relatives, friends, and Robert. We pray to the Lord. Creator God, you call Father Ted to shepherd your people, to boost morale, to feed the hungry, to walk with the restless, to encourage community, to build up the body of Christ. We pray in thanksgiving for his 50 years of priesthood, for the tireless service and fervent prayer. We pray that his boosts will empower us to uplift one another and so herald the coming of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Of our service of you, so that what you have done. are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. So with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the host of stars in heaven, you sing to him of your glory as without man we have lived.
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life.
us all, not in our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Right, where he's concerned. by the grace of God, has maintained his goal, here to serve. Sometimes resting with the laws of the church, but always believing that he was doing God's will. I read from the book of Ecclesiastes, and it reminded me so much of he. For it states that there is a proper time for everything. And he has taken 50 years to show us, by his example, that there is a right time for everything. He has constantly lived in some form, a time to be born. He was born. A time to die. He died every time he looks at me. A time to plant. He's tried to plant the Spirit of the Lord so many times with me, but I keep coming back to the church, so it must be working. A time to harvest. Waiting on the harvest. A time to heal, I'm sure there'll be time when he'd like to done that to me too. And a time to heal, he's healed me so many times. A time to destroy, I might destroy him, I don't think he'll destroy me. And a time to reveal, we're constantly rebuilding something in this community. A time to cry, we've cried many times. And a time to laugh, and you know him, there's always something to laugh about. A time to breathe, and a time to dance. A time for scattering stones, and a time for gathering stones. A time to hug, a time to be hugged. A time to find, a time to lose. A time for keeping, and a time for throwing away. A time for care, and a time to repair. A time to be quiet, and a time to speak up. A time for loving, and a time for hating. A time for war, and a time for peace. He worked so hard. I sometimes wonder, is God in control? Is it necessary for him to work so hard? What does he gain by working so tirelessly? I thought about this in connection with all the various kinds of work he does for all of us. My own conclusion is that God has given to us one in a million. Everything is appropriate in its own time. And he never seems to shy away and call upon. God has planted the gift of giving and love for the priesthood in his heart. The he I speak of with respect and love is Father Theodore Gilbert Temple. And while I don't always measure up to God's expectation, definitely not Father Ted's, and definitely not my husband Otis, I have learned that sometimes it's okay to get tired, and that we all fall down. But through hard work, we get back up. There is nothing better for a man than to be happy and enjoy himself as long as he can. And second, that he should eat and drink and enjoy the fruits of his labor. For these are gifts from God. I see this and more in Father Ted. I am honored to know him as a pastor and of freedom. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father Ted, for coming to see serve and not be served. You are truly one in a million. Happy 50th anniversary.
Number 545, sing to the mountains, 5.